When I was a kid, there were these little anthills at the beach with little ants running around. I did this thing where I would pour some sand on top of the anthill, and the ants would like dig themselves out and reappear on the surface. And I felt in the late 80s, early 90s that I was like one of those ants. So many things have happened that I wouldn't have predicted. Starting with that I would be a primary care doc. I mean, when I was in medical school, all of the respect went to people that went into esoteric specialties. Just being somebody's doctor, their general doctor, was seen as less. And yet, emotionally for me, it ended up being something that was just such the right thing. In the 1980s, being a gay man was kind of an awful scary time because sex was associated with death, and there was all this, you know, how do you date and what do you do, and you know, is this mole like the beginning of KS? In 6 months I'll be dead, and what about this cough? And especially before there was a test, so that was a stressful place to be, stressful place for me as a gay man. The AIDS thing in the 80s to me felt sort of like a battle that was occurring on the ground, but with no like generals or anything. It was just all the troops trying to fight this war without any direction or support. My training sort of coincided with the occurrence and the growth of the AIDS epidemic. So I saw the whole thing unfold starting in 81 when I started med school, is when the first cases of gay men getting sick. By 85, when I graduated, they'd identified the virus. And then as a resident, you spend most of your time in the hospital. And then I saw all these folks dying of AIDS, and a lot of them are my friends. So then when I started in practice in 1990, I actually had people come to me who I'd known or dated or whatever, come to me as patients, and that was the strangest, most surreal thing. I sat with a number of people as they died. There was a guy who was receiving hospice care at home. At a certain point, he became comatose, wasn't eating. You can kind of tell when things are really nearing the end. I came, and the three of us were sitting around the bed as his breathing slowed and ultimately died. It was a Saturday. It was kind of gray out. And right after his last breath, which is often is, was like this long sigh. And right after that happened, this rainbow appeared in the sky. And the three of us that were with him, we all just looked out the window, looked at each other. And it was really, we knew why it was there. For a little while, I became very angry too at this disease. And so I didn't want to soften things by saying things like passed away. So I would say died, because it seemed passed away was like a euphemism for the horrible thing that had just happened. Throughout the early 90s, there were little bits of hope. So we had a couple drugs by then for HIV, but they didn't make people that much better, and people still died. If you looked back now at literature written in 96, no one knew that things would work out as well as they did. So that's what's so strange about this time. It's very different from now, where if I prescribe a medicine, I can tell the person what the effect will be. Back then, nobody said, if you give people these three drugs, including a protease inhibitor and two more, that they're actually going to rise from the dead. Like I saw patients in Bailey Boucher who were on hospice, who were planning their last days, get better and walk out of Bailey Boucher. And I mean, I just felt like I'd fought this evil spirit, this AIDS spirit, And now I had better ammunition for it. You know, I could throw more things at it, and it looked like actually it would cower. I loved, in the late 90s, I loved things like, I got on the bus and the bus driver was somebody who otherwise would be dead, but they weren't because of the meds. And, you know, my patient, right? So I'd like wink at him on the bus. Like, we had our thing. And some of these folks feel like I saved their life. I don't feel that I saved anybody's life, but I feel like I was the conduit for a treatment that had come out that saved their lives. Some physicians have said, oh, AIDS care is boring now. But it's still very rewarding in a lot of ways. One way is I take care of a lot of the folks who were diagnosed when they were told they would only have 12 to 18 months left on the planet, and here they are 30 years later. That's an incredible emotional relationship, because I knew them when we were together facing some horrible thing. It's a great adventure, right? It's been much more fun that way than if 30 years ago I knew exactly what my path would be for the next 30 years. Surprises are more fun, especially when they're good surprises. Been a wonderful, wonderful path to the Emerald City.